November 28, the 10th day of the workshop, starts with sharing the experience with experts from the UNICEF. After a formal welcome and brief introduction by the project secretary, Kalyan Singh Kothari.
Manjari ji, हमारे बीच में हैं, तो हम आपका बहुत-बहुत स्वागत करते हैं, faculty की सब सदस्यों की तरफ से और राजस्थान यूनिवर्सिटी की तरफ से और UNICEF की तरफ से भी.
UNICEF Rajasthan Education Specialist Sulagna Roy and Communication for Development Specialist Manjari Pant are the two experts joined the first technical session to listen these observations. One by one, participants shared their experience with the experts.
They love the school, they love the midday meals, but what I found that the children were really, they were half the size of the city kids. Mm. Now the city kids, I have a 20-year-old and I have been through, you know, growing up milestones and all, these kids seem to be extraordinarily tiny.
Mm. My observation that I shared yesterday also, and I really came to share with you, the first thing I found, the transportation. Transportation means I found that the first class students and class 3 students, they are coming from 3 kilometers by walking to the school. And probably this may cause the kind of drastically attendance issues also.
But when the government schools that we went to offer the parents that we have a transport system, but you'll have to pay a nominal fee. The parents have this conception ki ye to free school hai. So transport ke bhi paise kyun hai? Although they are giving that amount to the private schools for the buses, but they are not ready to pay for the transport here. And it is only the primary classes where the parents do not want their children to go alone.
You mentioned, you know, that the names of the students were like strikingly very masculine. So they have named their doctors something like doctors, Sanjay. Yeah. So we asked, you know, why Sanjay? So they said that we have named them because it is a, you know, kind of a tradition in our family, yeah, that if you name a girl child as a boy, then the next child would be a boy. So that, you know, gender, you know, that thing, you know, that is
need for a boy,
did not change.
उनको एक hope चाहिए, need चाहिए, चाहे वो state government हो, चाहे वो UNICEF हो, कोई भी health को लेके. Education तो वो खुद अपने level पे schools के through कर रहे हैं. और जैसे दो चीजें अच्छी थी, drinking water के लिए उन्होंने बहुत अच्छा, toilets उनके अच्छे थे. एक जैसे government ने sanitary napkin की एक machine वहाँ लगाई हुई है, वो चालू नहीं है, मतलब install कर दिया और वो वैसे की वैसे रखी हुई है. वो हमने उनको एक सजेशन भी दिया है कि इसको या तो ऑन कराएं, कुछ भी कराएं, बस हेल्थ के लिए उनके पास कोई ऑप्शन नहीं है. एक हॉस्पिटल हेल्थ का वन पड़ा है तो वो लोग जयपुर ही आ गए.
After carefully listening these issues, Education Specialist of UNICEF Rajasthan Sulagna Roy has explained the role of UNICEF in developing standard of education in the state.
If you don't give your inputs in the Shala Darshan or Shala Darpan, you don't get funds. You don't know what is happening. You don't get PLF. You don't get things. So they quickly went to the nearby cyber cafe and they started doing it. Then they realized, hey, we get a lot of salary. Each one of them bought computers. So that way it is very, very good, and most of the schools have computers. Electricity and annual management of computer is still an issue, but these are all things, and but it goes slow and slow and slow. Things happen very fast, but now this these things which are very important will take a little time to address, because this needs a lot of, you know what, you have to be very diligently following it up. Yeah, you have to have where to go, what to do and all. So this is the situation in which we are, in fact, for me it has been a very good experience career-wise. Before this I was in West Bengal and all, and even in Rajasthan, I've been here since 2008, but this last 3 years, the success, being able to be part of this, has been very satisfying the way it has gone.
Second technical session of the day begins with the question, how communications for development create the theoretical framework for achieving the overall developmental goal? UNICEF Rajasthan's Communication for Development Specialist Manjari Pant highlights the importance of communication in attaining the efficacy of any developmental program.
Point is, the consciousness for class and for a structure in that class where there are different levels of hierarchy, that consciousness is high in this society. And maybe that's one of the issues that you want to change, so that everybody gets an equitable opportunity and has the capacity to take it forward. So those are the issues that your people should be able, your students should be able to understand. So a proper causal analysis is what I'm looking at. कि क्या आपके जो students आते हैं, क्या वो लोग बात की तह में जाने की capacity रखते हैं? और फिर उनके लिए क्या टेक्निक्स यूज करते हैं, पार्टिसिपेटरी टेक्निक्स यूज करते हैं, क्वांटिटेटिव करते हैं, देन दैट्स योर थ्योरी. आई एम नॉट गेटिंग इनटू दैट एट ऑल. व्हाट आर द वेज टू गेट टू दैट, टू द बॉटम ऑफ इट? यू आर बेटर जजेस. बट दिस इज व्हाट आई नीड व्हेन आई गो टू द गवर्नमेंट और व्हेन आई गो टू द CSR और द NGO एंड दिस एनडीए सेइंग कि हाँ, हम चाहते हैं कि ज्यादा से ज्यादा लड़कियां पढ़ने आए और शादी ना हो उनकी, या अगर हम कहना चाहते हैं कि शादी होने के बावजूद लड़की अपनी पढ़ाई कंटिन्यू कर सके और वो एक बेहतर होता है, तो देन वी नीड टू गो बैक डीपर इनटू दैट. एक बेसिक सिचुएशन एनालिसिस के कॉजेज में जाकर के, डेप्थ में जाके स्ट्रक्चरल और अंडरलाइन रीजंस को निकाल पाना और उसके बेसिस पे अपने प्रोग्राम की संरचना कर पाना इज द फर्स्ट थिंग दैट वी आस्क फॉर.
An interactive session ends with the vote of thanks delivered by UNICEF communication specialist Sucharita Bardhan. She appreciates all the participants for their sharp observation and active participation in the field trip.
The formal email group also of sorts, so that this learning continues beyond the session. And this group is supposed to be very important for us, because you are the first group that is pre-testing this. And before we kind of advocate and take it up to UGC, we have to see how to fine-tune a little more and make it a little more crisper. Maybe even go to the level of not only a module, but also looking at some lesson planning. That is my next challenge, but I intend to see how it goes. As far as C4D is concerned, this is just a kind of a glimpse into the large thing, world that she actually works in. And many of you who are associated with the C4D in some way or the other, you know the importance, relevance, and the finer details that need to be worked out. Thank you very much, Manjali, for giving them that overview. But we really have to make a move.
After a thoughtful and brainstorming session, participants are taken for an exposure trip to witness the higher education system of the state and to understand the modern printing technology used by newspaper organization. During this exposure trip, participants were got an opportunity to visit the library exclusively designed for the journalism and mass communication professionals. The library is set up by University of Rajasthan Center for Mass Communication head Professor Sanjeev Bhanawat in his Tilak Nagar, Jaipur residence. In the memory of his beloved mother, he has set up Dr. Shanta Bhanawat Institute of Higher Learning and Research Center. Under the center, he developed the state-of-art library, which stored more than 13,000 books and journals for the researchers and communication experts. After visiting the library, participants were guided to the University of Rajasthan and Center for Mass Communication to witness the journalism and mass communication education facilities in the state. Being the founder head of the department, Professor Sanjeev Bhanawat briefed the objectives and journey of the department to the participants. He also showed the classroom, studio, production control room, and discussed on the various programs offered by the department. As part of the exposure trip, participants were taken to the Dainik Bhaskar printing plant to gain hands-on experience on the modern printing process and newspaper production technology. Under the guidance of Professor Sanjeev Bhanawat, participants were visited various printing units and saw the printing process in detail. Production manager of Dainik Bhaskar explained the printing process and showed the modern printing technologies used in newspaper industry. He also narrates the technical aspects of the printing and thoroughly explains the computer to plate making process. Being one of the largest circulated deli of the country, Dainik Bhaskar uses state-of-art printing technology. This exposure trip set as a lifetime experience for the participants.